Hi guys, and welcome to this comparative analysis session by Intellipaat. So we live in a digital era which is dominated by softwares, and these softwares are built on one or the other programming languages. And today we are going to compare and contrast three such programming languages in Python, R and SAS. But before we get into all of that, please subscribe to our channel to never miss an update from Intellipaat. Now let's talk about today's agenda. So we'll start today's session off with a brief introduction to Python, R and SAS. And then we'll move on and talk about the industry fields in which these programming languages are being used. After that, we'll talk about the real-life applications of Python, R, and SAS. And then we'll talk about the community as well as the support for these languages. And then finally, we'll discuss the job scopes as well as salary for all of these three languages. Also, guys, we do provide end-to-end training on Python, R, and SAS. So if you're interested, you can check out the course details given in the description below. Now, without wasting any further time, let's just get into the session.
Introduction to Python, R and SAS. First, we'll see about Python. So Python is a high level interpreted and interactive language that is used in various fields of development. So it is also an object oriented and a scripting language that is designed to be highly readable, and it uses English keywords frequently, whereas other languages use punctuation. And also it has a fewer syntactical construction than other languages. So Python is a must for any working professional to become a great software engineer, especially when they are working in the field of various fields like web development, data science, machine learning, artificial intelligence, and big data. So the features that makes Python unique is easy to code. It is a very simple language that anyone can learn very easily. And it is also free and open source. Then it is an object-oriented programming language. So it supports object-oriented style or technique of programming that encapsulates code within objects. So it is also, Python also supports GUI applications that can be created and ported to many system calls, libraries, and Windows systems such as Windows MFC, Macintosh, and the X-Window system of Unix. So it is also a high level programming language. It is extensible that you can add low level modules to the Python interpreter, and the modules enable programmers to add to or customize their tools to be more efficient. So this extensible features makes it more unique for the use in various development tasks. Then it is a portable language and that can run on a wide variety of hardware platforms and has the same interface on all the platforms. Then comes integrated language, so it can integrate various other applications and technologies. Then Python is an interpreted language. So Python is processed at runtime by the interpreter, and you do not need to compile your program before executing it. And this is similar to the programming languages such as Perl and PHP. Also, it has a large standard library which makes the development in the various fields such as web development, desktop application development, software development, data science, big data, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. And finally, it has a large standard library. So there are various libraries and packages which helps in the field of web development, desktop application development, data science, big data, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. So these features makes Python a very unique programming language for development, and it is widely used across the industries, and there are top multinational companies who uses Python for their development tasks.
Just a quick info, guys, Intellipaat does provide end-to-end training on Python, R, and SAS. So if you are interested, you can check out the course details given in the description below. Now let's just get back into the session.
Now moving on to the next part, that is R programming language. So R is a programming language and software environment used for statistical analysis and graphics representation and reporting. So R is freely available, and it is an open source programming language. So the core of R is an interpreted computer language which allows branching and looping as well as modular programming using functions. So R also allows integration with procedures written in the programming languages such as C, C++, .NET, Python, or Fortran languages. So there are various features of R programming language. So it starts with open source, then it is a comprehensive language. It has a wide array of packages that is used in the statistical analysis. Then it has various graphical libraries that are used in data visualization tasks. So the task of data visualization can be handled using R programming very efficiently. Then it does not need any compiler for compiling its codes. It also performs fast calculations. And the next feature is integration with other technologies. So it can very efficiently integrate with other technologies to develop software applications. And then cross-platform compatibility. That is, R is platform independent. It can run on any hardware or more than one hardware or operating systems. So R is a well-defined and simple effective programming language which includes conditionals, loops and user-defined recursive functions and input output facilities. It has an effective data handling and storage facility. Also, R provides a suite of operations for calculations that helps in the analysis and visualizations of the data. And R provides various graphical facilities and libraries for data analysis that you already know. So as a conclusion, R is world's most widely used statistical programming language, and it's the number one choice of data scientists, statisticians and researchers who works on data. It is supported by a vibrant and talented community of various contributors. Now we will move on to another programming language, that is SAS. So it stands for Statistical Analysis Software. Going to the definition or detail, SAS is a software suite that can mine, alter, manage and retrieve data from a variety of sources and perform statistical analysis on it. And SAS provides a graphical point and click user interface for non-technical users. So it allows for data to be read from databases and spreadsheets from various statistical analysis. So SAS is a leader in business analytics. Through innovative analytics, it caters to business intelligence and data management. So it gives various software and services for business analytics. SAS transforms data into insight which can give a fresh perspective on business. So unlike other BI tools available in the market, SAS takes an extensive programming approach to data transformation and analysis rather than a pure drag and drop and connect approach. This makes it stand out from the crowd as it gives much finer control over data manipulation. And SAS has a very large number of components customized for specific industries and data analysis tasks. Also, SAS is a platform independent programming language, which means you can run SAS on any operating system, either Linux or Windows. Now, let us look at some of the features of SAS. So, it helps in strong data analysis. It is highly flexible. It helps in efficient data management, support data encryption algorithms, support various types of data format. So we have SAS Studio where we can implement the queries or codes of using SAS programming for data analytics. Then finally, it has a report output format that we can get. Now, we'll move on to the next part, that is fields of usage for these programming languages. So talking about Python, it is widely used for various sectors or various development fields such as web development, desktop application development. It is used for GUIs. It is used for game development, big data analytics, data science, machine learning, and deep learning. Python has a wide set of libraries used in various development fields. So for web development, it uses Django, Flask. And for GUI, it uses Tkinter. For game development, it uses Pygame. And in big data, data science, machine learning, and deep learning, there are various libraries such as Pandas, Scikit-learn, SkyPy, NumPy, TensorFlow, Keras, Cafe. So there are n number of libraries Python has to develop various applications.
Just a quick info, guys, Intellipaat does provide end-to-end training on Python, R, and SAS. So if you are interested, you can check out the course details given in the description below. Now let's just get back into the session.
Now, talking about R programming, so it is basically used for data mining, data analysis, data visualization, and it is also used for building predictive models in data science, machine learning, and the main purpose of using R programming is statistical computing. It is mainly used by industries or organizations to analyze the data, to visualize the data, and draw some meaningful insights from it by using statistical computing. So this is the sole purpose of using R programming. So it also has a rich set of libraries that helps us in performing various techniques of data mining, analysis, and visualization. Now moving on to the next part, that is SAS programming. SAS, that is statistical analysis software. It is used to output the statistical analysis in the form of tables and graphs, which is processed from spreadsheets and databases. The significant use of SAS is in the financial analytics. So it offers the full range of statistical functions and also provides the best GUI for data analytics application deployment. So it is used in advanced analytics, data management, business intelligence, and predictive analytics. So SAS is preferred over Python and R when the organizations need to analyze and visualize their financial data, and which needs confidentiality. So that is why SAS is a very expensive software. Now we will look at the applications of Python, R, and SAS. So starting with Python programming, so it has various applications. So Amazon, Twitter, Flipkart, YouTube, Google, Facebook, and there are many more Fortune 500 companies who uses Python programming for developing their robust softwares. So talking about Amazon, so it uses Python for their recommendation engines. There are various libraries and packages in Python which helps in developing machine learning algorithms that runs the recommendation engine. And same is the case with Flipkart. It uses recommendation engine, which again involves the usage of Python programming. Then talking about Twitter, so it uses Python for analyzing and text analysis for the users. So same is the case with YouTube. It analyzes its data of customers. And then talking about Google, so there are various applications of Python, and Google uses Python for implementing natural language processing, for implementing its text analysis, optimizing the search results of the website. Then same is the case with Facebook. Now moving on to the applications of R programming. So here are the companies, that is Gartner, Deloitte, Genpact, Ford, McKinsey, and Facebook, Google again, then Zalando, which is again an e-commerce website, and Paytm. So they uses R programming for analyzing and visualizing their business data and implementing machine learning algorithms to make predictive models. Then coming to SAS programming, here are the companies, that is Amazon, Netflix, YouTube, Twitter, Fractal, Cognizant, HP, Citibank, Dell, and it also consists of various other Fortune 500 companies, that is Google, Tesla. So these all uses SAS programming for their business analytics. So there are a very few companies who uses SAS for their business intelligence tasks, and not all companies can afford SAS programming because it is a very expensive tool to use for their organization. Now moving on to the next part, that is support and community for these programming languages. So starting with Python, so it is an open source programming language and it provides no customer service. So you have to search for your doubts and queries in Google. But it has a very large community of Python developers who are from various fields such as web development, They can be data scientists, machine learning engineer, data analyst, big data engineers, game developers, and many others. So it has a very large community that can help you out in solving your queries. Now, moving on to R programming. So again, it is an open source and free tool, and it does not provide any customer service, and it has a large community that can help you out to solve your queries, your doubts, and various R professionals who are expert in R programming and working can help you out in various data analytics tasks that you need to perform. Now, coming to SAS, so it provides a 24/7 customer service. As it is a paid tool and it is a very expensive tool to use, so it has a very good customer service. So you can clear all your doubts, and there is also SAS community that can help you out if you are stuck in a particular problem. Now, let us move on to the final part of this video, that is job scope for these programming languages. So starting with Python and talking about number of jobs. So according to Forbes, in India, there are 15,000 plus jobs available for Python developer in 2020. And in the United States, the number of jobs are more than 50,000. So it is a very big number, and there are a plethora of opportunities for a Python developer. Talking about salary, so the average salary in India is 7,25,000, and in USA it is $1,15,500. Then moving on to the R programming, so number of jobs for R programming according to Indeed.com. In India, there are 2,500 jobs available for R professional in 2020. And in the United States, the number of jobs are close to 8,000. The average salary for R professional in India is close to 6,53,000 per year. And in the United States, it is close to $1,05,000 per year. Now, moving on to the next part, that is SAS programming. So number of jobs according to Naukri.com. In India, there are 1 to 4, 5 jobs available for a SAS programmer in 2020. And as per the stats from Glassdoor, for SAS programming, there are 4,518 openings in the United States. And the average salary for SAS programmer is close to 5,40,000 rupees per year in India. And in the United States, it is $1,10,000. Now, for choosing a career option, if you are into financial analytics, then you should go for SAS programming. And for getting into the field of web development, data science, big data, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and development of games, you should definitely go for Python, as it is a widely used programming language and it has a plethora of job opportunities with a very good salary. So you must go with Python. Now, if you want to get into the field of data analytics, then you should go with R.
Just a quick info, guys, Intellipaat does provide end-to-end training on Python, R, and SAS. So if you are interested, you can check out the course details given in the description below. So this brings us to the end of this session. I hope you found it useful. If you have any queries, you can leave a comment down below and we'll reach out to you immediately. Thank you so much for watching, guys.